So we have a stripped down battle wagon for you, so hopefully you got some inspiration for the day. Oh, you want more? Okay, I get it. We've got a few pieces here. The client actually asked for every option magnetized. He wants all options on there. One thing that we do is the extended or the extra armor. We just kind of glue those on because magnetizing those, they break off all the time. The magnets do. They don't stay very well. You'll notice there's some magnets all over this thing. Some things we don't magnetize. We just set on there if we can remember how it goes. Looking at it backwards, I'm kind of messed up. But the ARD case with the turret on top. The turret, we've got a few weapons here. If you want a big zap gun, we can go there. If you want a lava, we can go there. Where's my...
And all of these there options are magnetized?
All options are magnetized there. Oh, no, there's the big zap gun, sorry, that's the cannon. And then the Defrola kit comes with the, what is that one called? Is that the kill cannon? I can't remember. It's been too long since I played Orcs. Don't shoot me. Okay, so we got those. Oh, and then on the sides, magnetized up for the, what the heck are they called? Stick chuckas, stick bomb chuckas. Brain fart. Anyway, too many things to remember. Okay, on the sides, we've got magnetized place for the gun there, or you can run with magnetized the gun there, or of course, you gotta be able to switch out with the rockets, so you can have those on there. So let's load this thing up. Our custom scratch-built Defrola here. You should recognize some of the pieces. The Orc bike kit, and we've got the guy over here, the little Grot, he's running it. So, it also counts as a Grot rigger, I guess, if you really wanted him to. That snaps on quite nicely, or you can run with reinforced RAM. I like the Defrola better, personally. It's more fun that way. And we have a grabbing claw, as well as the wrecking ball. Gotta have a wrecking ball. They're so much fun. Over on this side, got a boarding plank. Just makes more sense coming out there. Up in the front, just a little bit easier access. And what's a battle wagon without a couple of Grot riggers? Now this one, it's actually got two magnets because we put a magnet in the door here, but the magnet in the door was a little high, so he's got the force and floats a little bit. So the second magnet actually puts him down to where he needs to be.
That's awesome.
The big shooter on the back is not magnetized, but they're actually designed pretty well. They've got this little U. I don't know how well you can see that. But they fit on really nicely, and they don't fall off. So that's the only one that we did that way, just because I wanted to switch it up. Swap that out. Set that on there. We got big shooter, and you gotta switch out for the rocket. Completely orky, it just looks cool. Makes you laugh, it's fun.
That's and really awesome.
Of course, you can just run with just the hatches up on top, if you wanted to go that way. Another thing I thought would be kind of cool too, just have him sitting in there like he's hanging out in the hatch. So he can be moved around. Then we've got another big shooter over here. That one. So you can play around with this thing for hours, just having way too much fun.
That's every single option.
Yeah, this is all the options. Obviously, we can't figure out how to magnetize a red paint job just yet, but I'm working on that. So, yeah, everything in the codex you've got here available to you. It can take up to four either big shooters or rocket launches. So that's why they're kind of interchangeable. Mix and match there.
It's a lot of stuff.
It's a lot of stuff. And it's fun. Let's see. Here and there.
Wow.
So Hopefully, that was a little bit more inspiration than just a stripped down battle wagon.